Top 3 tips to drive without neck pain, back pain, or shoulder pain. Hi everyone, hope you guys have enjoyed your holiday so far. A lot of people are still spending a lot of time driving in their car. And so today I would like to hop on and talk about 3 very easy but very important tips that can help you to prevent or protect your neck, your back, or shoulders from hurting. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we need to pay attention to is how we hold on to our steering wheel. Instead of a very traditional way of holding the steering wheel in the 2 o'clock, 10 o'clock method that can really make your shoulders rounded, make you hunched over like that, it's now suggested that you should hold your steering wheel from the bottom, or it's the so-called 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock method. By doing that, you are able to engage your shoulder blades, the rhomboid, the mid-lower trap, to stabilize your shoulder blades better, and then that can decrease a lot of the tension that can develop in your neck or shoulder region. It's also a safer way to hold a steering wheel, just say when an accident happened and the airbag popped out. If you hold your arms up there, it can lead to shoulder arm injury and then even an eyeball injury in the case study, just because of somebody hitting their eyeball with the hand. If you put your hands at the 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock, your arms are clear from the area where the airbag can potentially pop out into. So it's a safer way, and also it's a better way to hold the steering wheel for your neck and for your shoulders. This is the first tip. The second tip is you can either find a towel roll or a very small pillow that can support your back. I have this little half dome shaped pillow that I can use because our lower back is a little bit of the curled situation, and so it's not necessarily always fit into the chair back that easily. But then if you have a little pillow like this, or if you can fold a towel roll or you put it behind your back, really fit into that curled region, you will feel that it supports your spine better, and then you have a much better base of support, more stable way to sit here when you are driving. That's gonna help you feel more comfortable. The back muscles can be a little bit more relaxed, so you don't feel a lot of tension bothering your back. So that's the second tip. The third tip is whenever you need to make a turn while you are driving, instead of turning your neck all the way, that might not be possible, or that might be very painful for a lot of people to turn your head to the extreme range. A very good way to do that is to actually use your arm to help. So if you are going to turn to the right, you put your arm to the other chair seat, and then you rotate with your entire trunk, so you don't need to rotate your head to the end range. You can already see further back. Same thing with the other side. Use the arm to reach onto the door frame, and then you can turn. So, third tip, instead of just turning with your neck, make sure you turn with your arms and your entire body. You have bigger range, and that's safer for your neck. So let's sum up the 3 tips real quick. The first is the 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock method of holding the steering wheel. The second is find a small pillow or a towel roll to support your back when you're sitting in the car seat. The third is turn with your arm and your body in addition to your neck. Very easy, but also very important tips to do, especially during this holiday season if you guys are doing any sort of traveling to see family or for vacation. Keep these in mind. But then with this being said, if you guys do have any issues bothering your neck, your shoulder, or even your back, feel free to reach out to us, and we would like to know your condition better and then maybe give you tips that are more specific to your condition. My name is Andy Zhen, physical therapist, occupational therapist, as well as the Pilates instructor at Core Therapy and Pilates. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at 512-215-4227 or email us at info@therapyandpilates.com or visit us at our website, therapyandpilates.com. Again, thank you guys for hopping on, and have a great day.